Okay, so I'm here with Dave Taylor from Siemens PLM at COFES. Dave, share a little bit about the session that you guys had. What were you sharing with some of the folks here, and what kind of feedback were you getting?
Yeah, so we had a session on mobility. We talked about started off the session with the discussion about the Team Center Mobility app that we launched last week. Gave the group a quick overview of what that was all about, and we actually had an opportunity to have a couple iPads here where we passed them around the room, and people had a chance to play with the app a little bit and see what it's all about. And it really prompted a lot of discussion about how something like our app and ultimately the iPad in general can be utilized in different parts of a manufacturing organization. So a lot of discussion around use cases in the plant, things like all the way from being able to have an iPad with data on it, travel with something like a bus, for example, as being produced, and having the people that are assembling it being able to access the information right on the iPad as the bus is moving through the assembly process. That was a very interesting idea. Being able to have iPads available for any number of maintenance type of applications where people in the plant are doing maintenance on equipment, even being able to do maintenance on vehicles or the product itself, and having the iPad have that kind of information on it. So very interesting dialogue around a lot of the different use cases that could be used.
It sounds like there's also the user manual type of application. I think the bus manufacturer person mentioned of leaving it with the bus so that it can then be that user manual. And there was also some discussion around like a pilot in the avionics industry, and how was he saying he would...
Well, sure. So pilots are inundated with information. So it's if you've ever sat in a cockpit of a small aircraft, you have the pilot's operating handbook. Ideally, you want to have documentation for any of the instrumentation that's in your plane, the data about the airports, the books of all the different airports in the United States, for example, change frequently as things change at the airport. So you see pilots walk around with these big briefcases. I mean, they're thick, and they have all this documentation in it. Well, you don't need that anymore. You can have it all in here and have this sitting next to you in the cockpit where you can access any of that information right here on your iPad. So that was an interesting use case also, that as a pilot, he was talking about being able to utilize it in that fashion.
There was also some interesting discussion and even some debate. You know, is this just a change in user interface to the same set of data? And what's maybe different or unique about that? Yeah. Just talk a little bit about that discussion.
That's good. So today, you know, our app and many of the others that are out there are really about consumption of data. And the dialogue that happened in the room today was more about, once we start to get people to understand how they can consume the information, does that then lead to a demand for apps that can author information? So, you know, today there's not a lot of demand for that because maybe people don't know so much about what they can do with this device. But as we start to give them more capability and access to better information, will they want to start actually using it as an authoring tool as well? So simple things like being able to use the camera on the iPad to take a picture of something, overlay that picture on top of some geometry, for example, be able to do comparisons, author issue reports, create sketches. You know, there's any number of things, and some even talking about full-blown CAD applications potentially being on the iPad. So while the demand isn't there necessarily for that today, it could be if the device can support it, and as users start to get more comfortable with what the device is capable of from a consumption standpoint, that flipping around to being demand for authoring as well.
The last thing I want to touch on was another kind of interesting facet of, we often talk about people having access to the PLM data who maybe aren't engineers or they're technicians in the field and people that aren't used to interacting with that kind of data. And it seemed like a number of these folks were excited to get their team members to be more excited about using PLM data. Can you just talk a little bit about
sure.
that?
Sure. Well, one of the things that the iPad in particular does, because of the user interface experience that you get through an iPad, is it simplifies everything. And what we've done with our app is we've followed that paradigm. So it's not the same Team Center user interface that you're used to seeing. It's not just delivering the web client through Safari. The app actually conforms to an Apple standard for how to do UI. So as people experience that, it's just much simpler for them. So now people who may be intimidated, or even casual users that may not want to have to relearn the learning curve of getting into a more robust application, they can sit down with this and figure it out pretty quickly. And so it takes the intimidation, if you will, out of the experience of working with something like PLM, and allows people who are very infrequent or casual users to be able to experience it and get value out of it through the mobile device. So I think a lot of people are excited about the opportunity of getting those kinds of casual users, whether they're maintenance people in the shop or people that are assembling the vehicle or the product, or even engineers, because engineers don't sit at their desks all day either. Designers may, but engineers are typically up and around. They're in the plant, they're out in the test track, you know, they're doing work around the vehicle if it's an automotive or heavy equipment or aerospace application, and they're very rarely at their desk. This gives them the opportunity to now interact with that PLM information wherever they are, and doesn't confine them to having to do it while they're at their desk.
So now I think we need to expand the tagline to anytime, anywhere, anyone.
That's a good point.
All right, thanks, Dave.